Are you aware of the silent battles happening inside your body? Understanding these links can significantly impact our approach to managing these conditions. Let's talk about how Parkinson's can cause neuropathy, the impacts of multiple sclerosis on the nervous system, and the higher chances of getting shingles and what it does to you. Throughout this video, I'll provide practical tips and actual steps to help you or your loved ones manage these health challenges effectively. Hi there, I'm Dr. Bao Thai. I'm dedicated to unraveling the complexities of neurological health and guiding you through the and managing these conditions. Let's talk about Parkinson's disease and how it can lead to peripheral neuropathy. Parkinson's disease is a neurological disorder that affects movement. It occurs when the nerve cells in the brain don't produce enough dopamine, a chemical that helps to control movement. People with Parkinson's often experience tremors, stiffness, and difficulty with balance and coordination. But Parkinson's doesn't just affect the brain, it can also impact the peripheral nervous system, which consists of all the nerves outside of the brain and spinal cord. This system controls sensations and muscle movements in your limbs. When Parkinson's affects these peripheral nerves, it can lead to a condition known as peripheral neuropathy. This means the nerves that carry the signals between the brain and the rest of your body aren't working properly. Symptoms of peripheral neuropathy in Parkinson's include weakness. You might find it hard to lift things or move your limbs with normal strength. Numbness, parts of your body, especially your hands and your feet, might feel numb or have a pins and needles sensation. Pain. Some people experience sharp jabbing pain or a burning sensation in their limbs. These symptoms can make everyday tasks challenging. Imagine trying to button a shirt when your fingers feel numb or walking when your feet hurt. It's important to recognize these symptoms early and talk to your doctor about them. Managing these symptoms often involves physical and cellular therapy, medications, and sometimes dietary changes to ensure that you're getting enough vitamins that support nerve health. Now, we'll explore multiple sclerosis, commonly known as MS. MS is a chronic disease that affects the central nervous system, which includes the brain and spinal cord. It occurs when the immune system mistakenly attacks the protective sheath that covers the nerve fibers called the myelin. This causes communication problems between your brain and the rest of your body. Two symptoms for taking into account: inflammation and neurodegeneration. In MS, T cells, a type of immune cell, plays a major role in this process. They cause inflammation, which damages the myelin and eventually the nerves themselves. This leads to the neurodegeneration, meaning the nerves are deteriorating over time. This inflammation in MS is similar to the inflammation seen in Parkinson's, but while Parkinson's primarily affects the brain, MS affects both the brain and spinal cord. The impact on the neuronal tissue can lead to various symptoms, including fatigue, difficulty walking, numbness, and muscle weakness. So what do you do if you have MS? First, you have to keep your nerves working and healthy. I found that therapies and treatments that help facilitate and activate Schwann cells are extremely beneficial. Also, regular exercise and a balanced diet are crucial. Exercise helps maintain muscle strength and mobility, while a healthy diet supports overall well-being and your energy levels. And the most important, our regular checkups with your doctor are essential to monitoring the progression of the MS and adjust treatments as needed. Psychological support is also important to help manage the emotional impact of living with a chronic disease, and joining a support group is crucial. Now, let's discuss shingles, also known as herpes zoster. Shingles is a viral infection caused by the reactivation of the varicella zoster virus, the same virus that causes chickenpox. Once you've had chickenpox, the virus stays dormant in your nerve tissues and can reactivate years later as shingles. Common symptoms include a painful rash, fever, fatigue. The rash usually appears as a stripe of blisters on one side of the body. A major complication of having shingles is postherpetic neuralgia, which is severe nerve pain that can persist long after the rash is cleared. So what do you do when you have shingles-driven neuropathy? You'll help facilitate the nerve repair process in your body. I'm talking about therapies that help the myelin sheath repair itself. It has been the absolute best way that I have seen patients recover from a shingles-driven neuropathy. You can also manage the pain with medications. Options include over-the-counter pain relievers, prescription medications, and topical treatments. Remember, the key is to use these medications as a bridge to help symptoms while you work on the damage to the nerve. So how do you prevent it from happening? Maintaining a healthy immune system through proper diet and regular exercise can help prevent reactivation of the virus. If you experience symptoms of shingles, seek medical attention properly to start treatment early and reduce the risk of complications. So, how are shingles related to Parkinson's and peripheral neuropathy? Interesting, shingles can have implications for both Parkinson's disease and peripheral neuropathy. Studies have shown that the older adults who develop shingles may have a slightly increased risk of later developing Parkinson's disease. This is thought to be related to the immune response and the inflammation caused by the virus. Now, the inflammation and the immune system changes associated with the shingles, can potentially affect the nervous system, leading to conditions like Parkinson's and peripheral neuropathy. Thanks, guys, for joining me. I know we've talked about a bunch of different things, and this is only surface-level stuff, but we try to explore the interconnections between Parkinson's disease, peripheral neuropathy, multiple sclerosis, and shingles. Now, understanding these relationships can help you better manage these symptoms and improve your quality of life. For Parkinson's, MS, and shingles-driven neuropathy, early treatment and care are the key to success. Remember, proactive care and regular checkups are essential in managing these conditions. Stay informed, stay healthy, and thank you for watching. And don't forget to subscribe for more insights on neurological and neuropathy health, guys.